everybody close your eyes and relax. What comes to your mind when you think of a river? How does the river flow? What does a river look like? What is the movement of the river? What are the things that comes in the way of the river as it flows? What are those places that the river flows through? How does the river change its course? What are the things that the river meet on its way? Okay, children, now slowly open your eyes. So you have imagined what I have been saying. You are going to draw that imagination on the chart papers that you have. In this lesson, I am using visualization method to teach poetry. This method helps the children in making the meaning of the poem by drawing, and also it helps them to understand the poem literally as well as figuratively. What you are going to do, you are going to discuss that drawing with your partners.
I have drawn a river which comes from mountain and it heads to a farm, and it's time of sunset and many birds come to drink water from here, and I have drawn fishes also and the birds are flying.
I have drawn a river which comes from jungle and there are trees at a side. Grasses are also there, fishes are there in my river and birds are flying above.
And I have drawn the rivers, two rivers are there and it meets together and it flows together.
Right? So now let the whole class know some of the examples like what has been discussed.
This drawing is made by my friend Drushti. She had shown their Kashmir view. The climate is too cool. The water are going and here she had drawn a bridge. The trees are there, here houses are there. The girl is making good cook and they are sitting here on the stall and they are eating.
This drawing is made by my friend Siddhi. In this drawing, she has shown that there are many mountains and from that mountain a river is flowing in which many fishes are there.
Students begin with what is familiar to them. I then help them to think and visualize what a river looks like by some guiding questions. And then I read the poem aloud and they try to understand and draw. After that, I try to bring their attention to some more important lines in the poem, and they add to the details of the drawings which help them to understand the poem better. The Brook by Alfred Lord Tennyson. I came from haunts of coot and hern, I make a sudden sally and sparkle out among the fern to bicker down a valley by 30 hills. For men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So children, now you all are going to read the poem silently and try to visualize what the poet is trying to explain, and then you are going to add those visualization to your already existing drawing.
He's very jealous about that humans can eat, but I can't eat. He sees the Phillips farm. Here's his house. There are two children who are playing with each
other. And is it joining for the two rivers?
Yes.
Now that you all have visualized the poem, I now want you all to mark some important lines of this poem. Just put a star marking in front of that line. You are going to read through the poem again. Keeping these starred lines in mind, then you are going to add those details in your drawing once again. The adding of the details is an important step in the process of visualization. It helps the students to discover the deeper meaning of the poem very easily. Now discuss with your partners what you have drawn.
There are two birds caught in the horn. This is the place where they rest and they have to go to the brimming river. So they have to cross the 20 villages which comes in the middle and the stones. And they go on chattering and chattering when they join the brimming river. And they don't cry that they are getting hurt of these stones.
Here is a man who is coming here to rest.
because here he spends a lot of time here, and here is a Bhutan one who comes here and sits for a while and then goes and drink water and he goes.
Now I want one of you to come up with your drawing and explain to the class.
Brook is flowing. It has to pass many obstacles from the pebbles. The pebbles are very sharp. There is a bird which is catching the fishes. The fishes are playing in the water. As there is a man where he goes and he is mortal, and the river is immortal. So he is died and the river goes out and away.
What is the movement of the brook?
Because of the difficulties which are in its way, its flow gets changed.
What are those hurdles or difficulties that the brook is coming across?
Bridges, towns, cities.
How is the journey of the brook?
The journey of the brook is very difficult due to the sharp pebbles. The brook journey is in fact nice also, but too many difficulties also you have to.
What do you think the poet is trying to convey to us?
In spite of the difficulties, the brook does not lose his hope. Same way, even if we are in difficulty, we must not lose our hope. We must continue our way and we must not turn back.
Now look into the drawing that you have and try to find out what are those similarities between the journey of the brook and the journey of life. In the next step, I help the students to move from the literal meaning of the poem to the figurative meaning of the poem. Visualization helps the students to think about a poem and picturize it in their minds. The picture gets more meaning when they add more details from the poem and relate it to their knowledge and experiences. In this way, they are able to discover the deeper meaning by themselves without any help from the teacher.
This poem relates to the human life, like the horns of Kutan Horn. Like the people have the horns of their boss, maybe. Like they give the pressure to the human being or to the workers that you have to do this much or you have to do. So they take stress and then they do anything. But in this poem, it explains like you have to not lose hope, but you have to do continuously. You have to go on trying. So you have to till you reach the success. You should never give hope. That's what the poet is trying to explain.
The first similarities of the curves of the river means the curves are so unusual that the river cannot cross, but however it comes out of that, it is related to our school. This is the exams which we cannot skip and we have to pass through that exam. And the second one are the stones and the pebbles. These stones and the pebbles are related to our life only. That means we have different tensions like school homework, tuition timings, drawing classes, etc. So we have to cross that and we have to do that thing.
So now we have seen the different views that you all have come up with, your visualization of the poem, what the poet has tried to explain and all. So here I would just like to conclude saying that the poet has used nature in a very beautiful way to explain to us how life can be difficult, but at the same time how it can be made easy, and we can reach our destination through all these difficulties and still have the smile on our face.